Hi, Patricia Akins, Sport Yoga Lady. So I just wanted to show you something that we discovered today while working out all those deep intrinsic hip, the muscles that I always talk about, the iliopsoas and the QL and the sartorius where it inserts. This little side plank variation identifies and helps you move them and see where you don't, what muscles you don't use, what muscles you overuse, all right? So we all know this traditional seated, it's like a half staff, right? And yoga pose, and we do a lot of twisting with it. What I want you to do with this is sit in that cross-legged, right? Knee, toes face the ceiling, and this knee that's bent, the feet face away, but I want you to square your shoulders off now this way, all right? And I want you to just come down to this stretch, kind of like a low lizard stretch, only you're coming forward. Now you see how my knee wants to bend, don't let it, get full extension, get a nice stretch. Now come open to the side, like you're gonna go to a side plank, and roll the body weight forward. Now, this knee can rest on this leg. You're gonna come down to a side plank on your elbow first, and you're gonna literally lift up to a side plank. And you're gonna just see what muscle of the hip. Now your hip has to be forward, you can't break. So you're not bent like that. The hip is perfect, your head is in line, but your hip is in line with the heel, all right? Good, nice. And I'll show you what I mean by that sideways. So you're gonna lay, get your head in line with your hip, in line with the heel, right? So it's like you're doing that inside leg lift, this leg is in front. If that's hard, what you need to do is get this foot flat, toe face forward, externally rotate this bottom leg so the inside, the MCL and the ankle bone are facing the ceiling, and then you roll sideways. So now your heel, your hip, and your shoulder are in line, and you're in your forearm for a plank, and then you lift, and you can't break at the waist. And you go 1,000, 2, and come down. And then do it again, hip forward, whoo, and come down. Awesome. Whoa. Then you can do that. You can repeat it 5 to 10 times. You can go up and hold it for 10 seconds and repeat it several times. You'll find your spots that are tighter than not, okay? Now do a little seated forward fold and transition to the other side, right? So get this foot facing that rotation. You're literally gonna rotate your whole thigh in the socket to get the knee facing forward. You're gonna roll sideways onto this hip to get this leg up. All right, and then you come down. You can go to this, get that little stretch first. It looks like lizard. Now when you're in forearm, fingertip can be forward or it can be facing away, whatever you want. Now just find here, get that alignment. You'll feel like the QL on the bottom. If you have fat, the adipose tissue is what we're gonna start calling it now, that's the thing. If you have adipose tissue, if you have a weak side when you ski, you have chronic hip stuff, torn groin, repetitive groin things, this is probably lower back pain. This might be a good one for you, all right? So then now you're gonna just come up. This side for me is so much easier. 1, 2, and 3. Now I'm breaking at my waist though. I'm gonna stop 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So if you noticed, when it was hurting, when I was losing my form, that's my weakest link. That's where I stopped and I stayed. A lot of these yoga, sport yoga is designed A, to identify and correct fairly quickly. So it's going to identify what your muscles you're overusing and underusing. And then we can very correctly fix it by staying there, moving through it, increasing the range or the strength, which if you're overusing or underusing, you're going to know. Make sense to you? You'll see. You go to hold, it hurts. All right, it restricts you. Can you move your hip forward? No, I can't. Okay, it's a tight muscle. And so now you have to move past that. How do you move past that? This hurts. I can't do it. So now we're going to leave our leg and we're going to just bring our hip forward. We're going to leave our leg on the ground to help stabilize and then transition up out of it. Once you kind of identify and teach your body how you want it to move, you'd be surprised at how quickly it acclimates. When you correct the movement pattern to kind of be the way it's supposed to be, it goes so easily. So So it's a faster, you heal yourself faster. All right, thank you for joining me with my side plank posture fixture, hip healer. Namaste, and I will see you again.